now we're going to use the bearing defender to troubleshoot. So let's set the scenario up. Maybe you get a call from a machine operator says, this bearing is running hot, or you notice a funny noise when you come by and you want to do a quick point and shoot diagnosis of that bearing. So that's what we're going to do now. I've got it set up on this bearing. As far as I know, everything's normal on this one, but we're just going to go through this process as if we were using the bearing defender to troubleshoot a problem. So I've mounted the sensor on here. My Bluetooth is paired. Now there's a couple things I can do. If I know the bearing, I don't have to, but if I know the bearing, I can put the bearing information in. So now let's go and do a quick diagnostic. I'm going to start collecting data on this machine. Now what I have here on this scale is I have a measurement in inches per second. Could be in millimeters if you can figure it that way. I've got a measurement in G's for acceleration. I have one in displacement in mils. This number is called a bearing defect number, and it's simply a linear scale. 0 to 6 is a normal bearing. 6 to 9 would be problematic. 10 and above up to 12 would be a problem. So now we're looking at the overall values on this bearing, and they look okay to me, but maybe I want to collect that data. So I'll touch on this red button here, and it's actually going to collect this data, save it if we want. It only takes just a few seconds to collect it. And now, all green tells me that I don't have a bearing problem, I don't have a misalignment or unbalance problem, so everything looks normal and it's color-coded. Green is good, yellow would be caution, red would be a problem. Maybe I want to see the spectral data. I can touch here on this corner, and I can actually look at what's called a zigstrom. And what a zigstrom is this. It's actually an overlay of the vibration spectrum, both in vertical, horizontal, and axial all at once. And you can do a screen capture of this and save it if your vibration analyst or whoever does your vibration analytics wants to see this. You can just save it for posterity's purposes if you want to. But the main thing I'm after is just getting that color code that tells me that this bearing is normal. So what can you do with a bearing defender? It's a great lubrication tool. I can actually just set this up and move it from bearing to bearing. If that bearing defect number is 6 or below, it probably doesn't even need grease or lubrication. But if it's above, I could put it on here. I could put my grease gun here, pump a couple of strokes of grease into this bearing, and what you would do is see that bearing defect number drop as soon as the grease hits it. So it's a great diagnostic tool. It's a nice little troubleshooting tool. Just if you want to know if what the operator thought he heard is true, if this bearing is making noise or running hot or whatever. So that's really the gist of the bearing defender. It's a great little tool for a point and shoot diagnosis on a bearing.